This is my evaluation of my slasher film, Warm Blooded. This is a 2-minute film of a typical story of a slasher where one character, the killer, kills the victim. The first question of my evaluation is, in what way does your media product use, develop or change forms and conventions of real media products? Our film used the same conventions that would be seen in a typical slasher film. The killer of the film was a male character, and this is seen as the typical killer for most slasher films. Films such as Texas Chainsaw Massacre and Friday the 13th use males as the killers because males are seen as the dominant and stronger gender. We used typical clothing of the killer that would be seen in most slashers. We used dark clothing to signify death and violence. This would add tension to the film. We also used a white mask for the killer, as most slashers such as Friday the 13th or Scream use a mask that signifies death and violence. By using a prop, such as the mask, this hides the killer's face and emphasises the enigma and adds excitement to the film as the killer is hidden away. I believe that my film also follows similar conventions of a slasher film by living in a patriarchal society, as our film does not consist of any women characters. However, the character who is being killed was also a male, and we changed the typical convention of the slasher film and tweaked it to using a male instead of a female as the victim. Instead of using the same convention of a woman being killed, we used a male character instead. We felt this would make our film more interesting and appeal to the audience, as we have listened to the results of the questionnaire, so it appeals to the audience more. We also used a typical slasher weapon. We used a meat cleaver, which is sharp and deadly. Most slashers use weapons such as knives and sharp objects. I believe this would make it scary, as the audience could relate to the objects that we use in everyday life. The location of our films are similar to typical slasher locations. We used a dark, dull and empty, abandoned and isolated house. We wanted to use this as it was very powerful from the moment you looked at it, and the abandoned house resembles its life and adds enigma to the story. This has also created a very realistic mise-en-scene, and this was powerful towards the audience. This location is also a typical location that would be seen in most slashers, where the victims are trapped in an isolated house with nowhere to run or help. An example similar to this is the Texas Chainsaw Massacre. We wanted to use this as we believed that this was effective and would scare the audience more, as they could relate to it. Our media film uses forms and conventions of real media products. In our film we use lighting, props, mise-en-scene and all the same functions that a film would use. The mood and light in the film is very dark and resembles death and dark and fearful moods. This is very similar and uses typical conventions of a typical slasher film. In our film, we also use red for the colour of our titles. Red signifies blood, death and danger, and we thought that by having red titles, this would emphasise the fear and signify the danger that is soon to come. We managed to plan ahead for a day where the weather was also going to be dull. We did this as most slashers use dull and horrible weather, such as rain, to connote the mood in the film and emphasise the fear and horror. We used a typical convention in our film, as the opening of our film starts as a foggy, dull and isolated field. How does your media product represent particular social groups? Our film represents males as being empowered over the women. The victim and the killer, who eventually gets finally killed, is around the age group of the people in the cinema that would view this film in the age range. Therefore, the audience would be able to relate to the situation, and this would increase the tension. All the characters in the film are men, and this would connote that men are more dominant and better actors than women are. Our film is based in a patriarchal society. The reasons we use a male in our film is because the men are seen as the stronger, more powerful actors compared to women. The stereotype of the slasher film is that the man is the killer, as they're the more dominant sex, and women is usually seen as the killer's target. The stereotype of the victim in the slasher is several teenagers, usually girls, are seen as the less powerful sex and more vulnerable compared to men. What kind of media institute might distribute your media product and why? If we were to distribute our film, I would use New Line Cinema as my distributor. New Line Cinema are an American distributor for films. New Line Cinema have been known for big history for distributing slasher films such as Texas Chainsaw Massacre and Nightmare on Elm Street. The Texas Chainsaw Massacre is also one of the most successful slasher films in history, and this is mostly down to the distributor being able to promote its films so efficiently. Therefore, I would try and interest this distributor into distributing our film, as this would give us maximum profit, as New Line Cinema is very successful and well known. An advantage of having an American distributor like New Line Cinema is that they are more successful than the British distributors. Due to the current climate and the recession in Britain today, British distributors do not have the amount of money that match to the American distributors, and this can be seen as a big benefit for our film. Using a big distributor such as New Line Cinema would be very beneficial, as this would maximise our sales, views and profits. Who would be the target audience for your film? The audience of our media film would be people who are interested and enjoy watching horror and slasher films. Most likely they will have a good experience with slasher films and enjoy all the typical conventions of the genre, as this applied in our film. According to our research and questionnaire, males would be interested in slasher films, whereas females told us they do not prefer to watch the slasher films as they are too gory and violent. Therefore, we tried to reduce the blood and violence in our film so it would interest females as well as males. Ages from 14 up to 40 years old are the typical age group that appear at the cinema in general. From looking at research of cinema audience types, we discovered the main age that view slasher films are from 15 to 24 and most likely males. We have spoken to people from around the age group and we found out this would be the correct age group and they would agree with this conclusion. How did you attract your audience? Males are very interested in being spooked, and mindless violence is a big interest for males as they like gory films. Whereas research showed that males prefer not to watch slasher films and do not like the genre as much as the male audience do because of the gory scenes. Therefore, we tried to make our film so it would attract both genders and not make our film too violent or gory, which I believe we succeeded in. From looking at research, we found that teenagers and young adults watch slasher films. Therefore, we tried to make the characters around their age so the audience could relate to the film and this would interest the audience more. We discovered the target audience of this genre also like to see sharp, deadly objects in slasher films as this spooks out the audience more. To attract the audience more, we tried to listen to the research and questionnaire as much as we could so this would attract the audience, and by having a questionnaire, we knew that what people liked and how to drag them in. Therefore, we used a meat cleaver, which we believe was the spookiest weapon we could find. By also having a questionnaire, it makes the production of the film a lot easier to make, and the feedback from people is very helpful, and this would be used to improve the film. To find and address our target audience, we create and ask people to fill in a questionnaire about their views of slasher films and what they fear the most. A lot of people answered that screaming sharp, deadly objects are the scariest parts to assemble a good slasher. Therefore, we decided to create a film that will use our feedback and put it into production. By listening to the questionnaire, this will attract more of the target audience, and listening to most of the questionnaire, this will attract a wider audience and improve our film overall. For example, we include screaming into our film to add tension, fear and excitement. What have you learned about technology from the process of constructing this product? To create this film, our group used iMovie HD to produce and edit the film. We also used the software's effects, sound effects, animations and music to create the typical scenes from a slasher film. We used technology effects to keep the audience interested by using effects such as zingers. I learned that technology in films can be very difficult to use, as on the day of film we struggled to catch enough light into the cameras to catch the picture. To improve this, we had to use more torches to add the light. The location of the house was very dark. This made it very difficult to catch enough light to produce and watch it on the Apple Macintoshes. We also learned that software and technology made the end product of the titles very hard to match the mood. The iMovie software had very limited effects and the animations to add and create a suitable title, and this affected the film. I've also learned that the camera was faulty in the day and this made some of the recording and the data on the cameras corrupted. When we synced the camera through to the iMovie HD, some of the data was corrupted and we had to record some of it again, and this took up time and gave a lack of continuity. Through this, I learned that to get everything right, correct and flawless results and prevent any problems, we had to plan and prepare for the day ahead. Before we recorded on the day, we had to make sure everything was ready and tested so it could be used without any problems or faults. I learned that planning is vital in filmmaking. Everything must be prepared and have backup plans if something goes wrong. An important thing to include whilst making a film is the stillness of the shots, as this plays a huge role in how the audience enjoy the film. If the shot is handheld, this can create problems for the viewer, and still camera shots are preferred. To accomplish this, use a tripod. For For our film, we use an old and fragile house that has been expected to be abandoned for up to 45 to 100 years old. Therefore, we made a risk assessment for the location to prevent any accidents from happening and minimise danger. We also had to receive feedback for our film and what the target audience felt about our film and how we could improve it. We uploaded a copy of our film onto YouTube and Facebook for people to view and give us feedback. This was very helpful whilst making our film, as we could receive feedback from people to improve and tweak our film. We also made an animatic of our film from plans and drawing of clips of our film to produce a plan and first drafts of the film. We also used WordPress, where I could create a blog where I had to write down all my information, such as plans, preparation and tasks. Looking back at your preliminary task, what do you feel you have learned in the progression from it to the full product? Before creating my film, I had to make myself a preliminary task. This task consisted of creating a match and action shot where a character walks the door and opens it into the first shot, then into the next shot where it continues and follows through by walking through the doorway and closing the door behind him or her. This creates a visual bridge and disguises the cut from one shot to the next. This technique helps to create seamlessness and create a smooth flow for the audience. My group and I used this technique from when the homeless character walks into the entrance of the location. This was very effective and works very well, as it's seamless but excites the film and emphasises the film and makes it more exciting to watch. I learnt that the match and action shot is a good way to keep the audience on the end of their seat and yet make each shot exciting and tidy. This also gives two different views of the character and makes it clearer to see the character. This taught me that this can be used when the character is walking out of an old shot into a new shot and this will appear. I learned that to create the full product, the most important thing to do is the camera shots, so the quality of them should be good. The preliminary task also showed me how a still camera is better than a handheld, as the quality of the picture is better and handheld cameras make the audience feel sick and put them off. Another rule in the film is the 180 degree rule. This is where the character will walk from the left of the screen to the right and the camera will follow their move. Therefore, the camera will pan 180 degrees from left to right. The 180 degrees is very seamless and tidy, and this is preferred to be used on a tripod to make it successful. We use this in our film when the homeless character discovers the house. As he finds the house, he'll walk towards the entrance. As you can see, the 180 degree rule is being used to follow the character. From looking back at our group's preliminary task, I feel I've learnt from using lots of different shot types, such as using the match on action shot, visual bridges, and being able to use seamlessness through the film to make the film look professional, tidy, and also make the different shots less visible and a smooth flow between the shots to the audience. I've also learned from different techniques on how to add effect and enigma to the film by using the darkness and mise-en-scene to our advantage. I've learnt that films take time and lots of planning to create the film, and without the aid of planning, this will affect the film badly. To create a successful film, you need a well thought out plan. Thank you for listening to my evaluation on my 2-minute slash film, Warm-Blooded.